In this class, we are going to discuss about how to calculate first and follow. Now let's see how to calculate first. So in order to calculate the first, we have to follow three rules. The first rule is, if A implies A alpha, here capital A is nothing but a non-terminal, small a means terminal, whereas alpha means it may be terminals or non-terminals or combinations of both or some epsilon. So alpha belongs to V means non-terminals variables, union T means terminal symbols. So any occurrences of this combination including star. So if A implies A alpha, then we can say that first of A is nothing but, here it is starting with A, the corresponding production is starting with A. So then first of A is equal to within the curly braces A. So if there is a production like this, A implies A alpha, then first of A is nothing but small a. Now let us consider the second production. If A implies epsilon, if A produces epsilon, then first of A is nothing but, here it contains epsilon, then first of A is nothing but within the curly braces epsilon. So this is the second rule here. And the third rule is, if A implies BC, that means A contains two non-terminals, then first of A is nothing but, here it produces B and C, but what is the first non-terminal here? B. So then first of A is equal to first of B. If first of B doesn't contain epsilon, if first of B doesn't contain epsilon, okay, whereas if first of B contains epsilon, if first of B contains epsilon, then we have to substitute epsilon in place of B. So then what will happen is, then first of A will becomes, so here first of B contains epsilon here, so in place of B we have to substitute epsilon. So epsilon into C is nothing but C. So first of A will become first of B union first of C. So first of A will become first of B union first of C. And it should not contain, now if there is any epsilon symbol, it also contains that epsilon symbol. So by using these three rules, we can calculate first. Now let's see how to calculate follow. How to calculate follow. So in order to calculate follow, also we are having some rules. The first rule here is, if S is a start symbol, if S is a start symbol, then follow of S contains dollar symbol. If S is a start symbol, then follow of S contains dollar symbol. Why? Because we can use this dollar in top-down parsing techniques. And the second rule is, if A implies alpha B beta, if A implies alpha B beta, then follow of B is equal to, here in order to calculate the first, we have to search for always the left hand side non-terminal. So here what is the left hand side non-terminal? A. So we have to calculate first for capital A. Here also the left hand side non-terminal is capital A. So we have to calculate first for this capital A. Here also the left hand side non-terminal is A. So we have to calculate for first of A. But in order to calculate the follow, we have to search in the right hand side for the corresponding non-terminal. Here we are calculating follow for B. So we have to search for B in the right hand side. Here we have B here. Here follow means after B we have beta. So that means beta is following B here. So then follow of B will becomes first of beta. So what is follow of B here? Here beta is following B. Here alpha means it may be terminals or non-terminals or combinations. We should not bother about alpha. Whereas beta is nothing but a non-terminal. So what is beta here? A non-terminal. So non-terminal means some variable, some uppercase alpha beta. So then follow of B is nothing but first half beta. First half beta. If first half beta doesn't contain epsilon. If first half beta doesn't contain epsilon. Why? Because if first half B contains epsilon, then we can't place epsilon here. Why? Because here the follow cannot accept epsilon symbol. So in follow projection, we can't place epsilon. Okay. So this is the rule here. If A implies alpha B beta, then follow of B is nothing but first half beta except epsilon. Okay. If there is any epsilon symbol, then in place of that B, we have to substitute that epsilon. Okay. Now let us consider the next prediction. If A implies alpha B. If A implies alpha B. So A means non-terminal. So we should not bother about what is alpha. It may contain terminals or non-terminals or anything. Now here we are calculating the follow for B. So then follow of B is nothing but. Here after B, we don't have any symbol. So follow of B will become the follow of A. So if there is no non-terminal, if there is no symbol after the corresponding non-terminal, so what will happen? It will become epsilon here. Okay. So because anything into epsilon is nothing but that anything. So here there is no symbol. So follow of B will become follow of A. Follow of A. So this is the third rule. Now let us take the last rule. This rule can also be written as if A implies alpha B beta, where beta implies epsilon. So here what is the production? A implies alpha B beta. So alpha means it may be terminals or non-terminals or combination or some epsilon. Here we are calculating follow for this B. Beta is nothing but a non-terminal. Where what is beta? Epsilon. If you substitute beta production here. So what is beta here? Epsilon. Then it will becomes alpha B only. So then what is follow of B? Then follow of B is nothing but. So if you substitute this production here, then what will happen? Alpha B epsilon. So anything into epsilon is nothing but that anything. So here the result is alpha B. So there is no symbol after B. So what will happen now? It follows the left hand side non-terminal. So what is the left hand side non-terminal? Follow of A. So in this way, we can calculate the first end follow. Now with the help of some examples, we will try to discuss first and follow in detail. So let's see the first example. So now let's see the first example. E implies T dash. E dash implies plus T E dash R epsilon. So it contains two productions. The first production is plus T E dash. Second production is epsilon. Next one T implies F T dash. Next one T dash implies star F T dash or epsilon. Last one F implies left parenthesis E, right parenthesis ID. So now we have to calculate the first and follow for this grammar. So let us calculate the first. So first off, here in order to calculate the first, we always looks for the left hand side non-terminal. So we have to calculate first for E, E dash, T, T dash and F. So first off E is nothing but, here E produces T E dash. So first off E will become first off T. So what will happen now? We have to go to the production T. Next T produces F T dash. So it is starting with F. So once again, we have to go to the production F. So F produces two productions. The first one is left parenthesis E, right parenthesis. And the second one is ID. Okay. Here the first R follow will always produces terminals as the result. Here first means the starting symbol. In this production, the starting symbol is left parenthesis. Whereas in this projection, the symbol here is id. So left parenthesis comma id is nothing but the result of first of e. Why? Because here what is the production? E implies t e dash. So first of e is nothing but first of t, because it is starting with t. So now we have to search for the production t. So t implies f t dash. So first of t will become first of f. So now the control will goes to f. So first of f means here what is the first symbol here? Left parenthesis. Here the terminal is id. Now let us calculate first for e dash. So first of e dash is equal to, here e dash contains two productions. The first production is plus t e dash. Second production is epsilon. So here it is starting with plus and it contains epsilon. So first of e dash means plus comma epsilon. Now let us calculate the first for the next non-terminal. So the next non-terminal is t. So first of t. So here t produces f t dash. So first of t means first of f. So now let's see f. So first of f means, so what is first of s? Here we have two productions. The first production, first symbol is left parenthesis, and the second production symbol is id. So what is the result here? Left parenthesis comma id. Now let us calculate the first for the next production. So the next production here is t dash. So first of t dash is equal to, so t dash contains two productions. The first production is star f t dash and the second one is epsilon. This production is beginning with star. So star is the result here, and this production contains epsilon. So epsilon is also the result. Now let us calculate first for the last one. So what is the last non-terminal here? First of f. So directly we can write here, because it produces two productions. The first production is left parenthesis e right parenthesis. It is beginning with left parenthesis, and this one is nothing but id. So in this way we can calculate first. Now we have to calculate follow. So follow of, so again we have to calculate here the follow for the first non-terminal. What is the first non-terminal? E. So follow of e is equal to, here e is nothing but start symbol. So for any start symbol, the follow should be dollar. So first we have to add dollar to the follow of the corresponding e, because e is nothing but the starting symbol. The grammar is starting with this non-terminal. Here in order to calculate the follow, we have to search for this non-terminal in the right hand side. So we need to search whether is there is any capital E in the right hand side or not. So in the first production we don't have capital E, second production we don't have, third production we don't have, fourth one we don't have. If you take the last production, here we have capital E. Here we are calculating for follow of E. Here after E we have right parenthesis. This is nothing but follow here. So right parenthesis is following E here. So what is the result here? Right parenthesis. So we have to add right parenthesis to follow of E. Now let us calculate follow of, what is the next non-terminal? E dash. So follow of E dash. So in order to calculate follow of E dash, we have to search for E dash in. So in order to calculate follow of E dash, we have to search for E dash in the right hand side. So if you take the first production, what is the first production here? E implies T E dash. So here we have E dash here. But after E dash, we don't have any symbol. So follow of E dash will become follow of E. What is follow of E? Already it is calculated. So dollar comma right parenthesis. Dollar comma right parenthesis. Next, here also we have E dash. But after E dash, we don't have any symbol. So follow of E dash will become follow of E dash. So that is nothing but the result only. So dollar comma right parenthesis is nothing but follow of E dash. So now let's calculate follow of T. Follow of T. So we have to search for capital T in the right hand side. So the first production contains capital T. So what is that production? E implies T E dash. So phi of t will become here capital E dash is following t here. So phi of t will become first of E dash. So what is first of E dash? Plus epsilon. But epsilon is not allowed in follow. So in place of this E dash, we have to substitute epsilon. So if we substitute epsilon here, then the production will become T into epsilon. That is nothing but T. So now follow of T will become follow of E. So what is follow of E? This dollar and right parenthesis. So dollar and right parenthesis. So next set, is there are any other productions? So this also contains capital T. But after T, we have E dash only. So these two are same only. Okay. So now let us calculate follow for the next non-terminal. So T is over T dash. So follow of T dash is nothing but. So now we have to search for T dash in the right hand side. Okay. So this production contains T dash in the right hand side. So here the production is T implies F T dash. Here there is no symbol which is following T dash. So follow of T dash will become follow of T. So what is follow of T? Plus dollar right parenthesis. Now let us calculate follow for the last one. So follow of F. So now let us search for the productions which contains F in the right hand side. So here we have this production, third production. So T implies F T dash. Here T dash is following F. So follow of F will become the first of T dash. So what is first of T dash? First of T dash means star comma epsilon. So star comma, but we should not write epsilon here because epsilon is not allowed in follow. So in place of T dash, we need to substitute epsilon. So if you substitute epsilon here, then the production will become F. So now follow of F will become follow of T. So what is follow of T? Plus dollar right parenthesis. So in this way, we can calculate first and follow for this grammar. Okay. Now let's see the second example. So S implies capital A, capital B, capital C, capital D, capital E. A implies small a comma epsilon. B implies small b comma epsilon. C implies small c. D implies D or epsilon. E implies E or epsilon. So let us calculate first of S. So first of S. So first of S is nothing but this production. So it is starting with A. So first of S is nothing but first of A. So here what is the production? S implies A, B, C, D, E. So first of S is nothing but first of A. What is A here? A comma epsilon. A comma. But here we should not write epsilon here. Why? Because after this non-terminal, we have so many non-terminals. So we need to substitute epsilon here. So here what is A? A or epsilon. So in place of this capital A, we need to substitute epsilon here. So if we substitute epsilon here, then the result will become S implies epsilon into BCDE. That is nothing but BCDE. So now first of S will become first of BCDE. So here this production is starting with B. So first of S will become first of B. So what is first of B? B comma epsilon. So B, write B here. But we should not write epsilon here. Why? Because after this B, we have several non-terminals. So we need to substitute epsilon here. So what is capital B here? Epsilon. So in place of B, substitute epsilon. So if we substitute epsilon, then what will happen? Epsilon into CDE. That is nothing but CDE. So now first of S will become first of CDE. So it is starting with the non-terminal capital C. So first of S will become the first of C. So what is first of C here? C. Here there is no epsilon. So stop the process. So in this way we can calculate first of S. So now let's see one more time here. So what is S here? S implies A, B, C, D, E. So what is first of S? Here it is starting with A. So first of S will become first of A. What is first of A? A comma epsilon. So add A here. But we should not write epsilon here. Why? Because here we have several non-terminals here. Okay. So we need to substitute this A value here. So what is this A value? Epsilon. So substitute epsilon here. Then what will happen? This will be vanished. This will be removed. So now first of S will become B, C, D, E. So now first of S will become first of B. So what is first of b? B comma epsilon. So here we have b. So b. But we should not write epsilon here. So substitute epsilon here. If you substitute epsilon here, then what will happen? Epsilon into CDE. So this b will be vanished. So CDE. So first of s will become first of CDE. So it is starting with C. So first of C. So what is first of C? C. So let us write C here. Now let us write first of A. So first of A means, so it contains two projections, A comma epsilon. A comma epsilon. Next, first of B. So it also contains two projections here, B epsilon. Here there is only one symbol here, in the first projection as well as in the second projection. Now let us calculate first of C. So first of C is nothing but, here we have only one symbol, that is nothing but small c. Next, first of D is nothing but, so what is first of D? D comma epsilon. Next, first of E is nothing but E comma epsilon. Now let us calculate follow. So follow of S. So in order to calculate the follow, we have to search for S in right hand side. But there is no S in right hand side. But here, what is S? S is nothing but starting symbol. So the follow of the starting symbol should contain dollar here. So follow of S is nothing but dollar. Now let us calculate for A. So follow of A. Follow of A. So we have to search for the non-terminal capital A in the right hand side. So here we have only one production which contains capital A. So what is that production here? S implies A, B, C, D, A. So here we are calculating follow of A. So here capital B is following A here. So what will happen? Follow of A will become first of B. Why? Because B is following A. Okay. So first of B. So what is first of B? B comma epsilon. So what is first of B? B comma epsilon. But I already said that follow doesn't allow epsilon here. So now in place of B, we have to substitute epsilon. So in place of this B, substitute epsilon. So now what will happen? A into epsilon into CDE. So that is nothing but A CDE. So we are calculating follow for A here. So now capital C, this C is following this A. So now follow of A will become first of C. So what is first of C? It contains only a C. So follow of A is nothing but BC. Now let us calculate follow of B. Follow of B. So let's see follow of B. So now we have to search for capital B in the right hand side. So here we have only one production. So what is that production? S implies A, B, C, D, E. Here we are calculating follow of B. Here the non-terminal C is following B here. So follow of B will become first of C. So what is first of C? C. So what is first of C? C. So directly substitute C here. Okay. Here there is no epsilon. Okay. Next, let us calculate follow of D. A is over, B is over. So next we have to calculate for follow of C. So follow of C. So let us search for the right hand side which contains capital C. So here what is the production? A, B, C, D, E. Here we are calculating follow of C. The non-terminal D is following C. So follow of C will become first of D. So what is first of D? D comma epsilon. But we should not write epsilon here. Why? Because follow doesn't allow epsilon. So in place of D, we have to substitute epsilon. So if we substitute epsilon here, then the production will become ABC. So epsilon in D is nothing but E, ABCE. So now we are calculating follow of C. So now capital E is following C here. So follow of C will become first of E. So what is first of E? E comma epsilon. So E comma. But we should not write epsilon here. So this one is nothing but E. So E comma. We should not write epsilon here. So in place of capital E, substitute epsilon. So in place of this capital E, substitute epsilon. So if we substitute epsilon here, then the production will become ABC. So then follow of C will become, here there is no symbol after capital C. So what will happen? Follow of C will become follow of S. So what is S? Dollar. Now let us calculate follow of D. Follow of D. So what is follow of D? So we have to search for the non-terminals which contains capital D. Okay, so what is that production here? S implies ABC, DG. Here we are calculating for follow of D. Here capital E is following D here. So follow of D will become first of E. So what is first of E? E comma epsilon. But we should not write epsilon here. So in this production we have to substitute E value. So what is here first of E here? Epsilon. So in place of this E, substitute epsilon. Then the production will become ABC D into epsilon. D into epsilon is nothing but D. Okay. So S implies ABCD. Now we are calculating follow of D. Here there is no symbol which is following D. So follow of D will become first of S. So what is, follow of D will become follow of S. So what is follow of S? Dollar. Now let us calculate follow for E. So follow of E is nothing but, so here no symbol is following E. So follow of E will become follow of C, follow of S. So what is follow of S? Dollar. So in this way we can calculate first and follow for these two examples. Now let's see some more examples. Now let us calculate the first and follow for these three grammars. So let us calculate first here. So first of S is nothing but, so S produces two productions here. The first production is BB, second production is CD. So first of S will become first of B. Here B is producing A here. So what will happen now? So first of B will become A. So here B also. So let us calculate first of S here. So first of S is equal to, so S produces two productions here. The first production is BB, second production is CD. So first of S will become first of B. So control B goes to B. So first of B will become A because it is starting with A. A comma, what is the next production here? Epsilon. But we should not write epsilon here. Okay. Here what is the production here? S implies BB. Here we have some non-terminal. So in place of that non-terminal, substitute epsilon here. So what is B here? Epsilon. So in place of B, substitute epsilon. So if you substitute epsilon, then it will become B. So first of S will become B now. So likewise calculate for CD also. So first of S will become first of C. So here what is the production? S implies CD. So first of S will become first of C. So now go to first of C. So C is produces CC. So CC is the first production, epsilon is the second production. Here it is starting with terminal symbol. So take the terminal symbol here. So what is the next one here? Epsilon. But don't write epsilon here. Here in place of this capital C, substitute epsilon here. So if you substitute epsilon in place of capital C, it will become S implies E epsilon into D. So epsilon into D is nothing but D. So first of S means ABCD. Now let us calculate first of B. First of B. So what is first of B? It produces two productions, AB epsilon. So here it is starting with A. So AR. So what is the next symbol? Epsilon. Next one, first of C. So first of C is equal to, it contains two productions. The first production is starting with the terminal symbol C. C comma, the second production is nothing but epsilon. So in this way, we can calculate first for this grammar. Now we have to calculate follow. So follow of S is equal to, so in order to calculate follow, we have to search for this non-terminal in the right hand side. But there is no S in the right hand side. So follow of S will become dollar because S is the starting symbol. So we have to add dollar to the follow of the starting symbol. Now let us calculate follow of S is over. What is the next production? B. Follow of B. So in order to calculate follow of B, so we have to search for the non-terminal capital B in the right hand side. So here we have two productions. First one is S implies BB. After B we have small b here. So let us write that production. So S implies BB. Here we are calculating follow of B. So after B we have small b. So small b is following capital B. So now follow of B will become this terminal symbol. So what is the terminal symbol here? B. And now let us search for capital B in the right hand side. Here we have one more production. So what is that production? B implies AB. Here we are calculating fall of B, but there is no symbol which is following capital B here. So fall of B will become fall of B. So that is nothing but fall of B. So what is fall of B here? That is nothing but B only. Next, let us calculate fall of C. Fall of C, okay. So search for capital C in the right hand side. So we have two productions here. The first production is S implies CD. So a terminal symbol is following capital C here. So directly we can write the terminal symbol D. So next one, so C implies CC or epsilon, okay. So C implies CC. So here there is no symbol which is following C here. So fall of C will become fall of C. So that is the one only we are calculating. So fall of C is nothing but D. So in this way we can solve this example. Now let's see the next one. So now let us calculate first and follow for this grammar. So here the first production is this one. S implies capital A, capital C, capital B, or capital C, small b, capital B, or capital B, small a. A implies small dA or capital BC. B implies small g or epsilon. C implies small h or epsilon. So let us calculate first of S. So here what is first of S here? Here it is starting with A here. So first of S will become, here we have three productions here. The first production is ACB, second one is CBB, third one is BA. So we have to consider these three productions in order to calculate first of S. So here the first of S will become first of A. So what is first of A here? So let us write the production. So S implies ACB. So this is the first one. And what is the second one? S implies CBB. Next one, S implies BA. So now first of S will become first of A. So what is first of A? Here it is starting with D here. D. And we have one more production, BC. So now first of A will become first of B. So what is first of B here? G or epsilon. So let us write G here. But we should not write epsilon here. Okay. Because here we have one more non-terminal. So in place of B, we have to substitute epsilon here. So if we substitute epsilon here, then what will happen? First of A will become first of B. So what is first of B? G comma epsilon. So that is already written here. Okay. So this production is over. Now let us consider the second one. So first of S will become first of CBB. So S implies CBB. So first of S will become first of C. So what is first of C? H comma epsilon. So write H here, but don't write epsilon here. In place of capital C, substitute epsilon here. So now this production will become BB. So now first of S will become this B. It is starting with B. So B. So now let us consider the last production. S implies BA. So first of S will become first of B. So what is first of B here? G. So already it is calculated. Next we have epsilon. Okay. Don't write epsilon here. In place of capital B, substitute epsilon here. So if you substitute epsilon here, then the production will become A here. So first of S will become A here. So this is the first of A. All terminal symbols. A comma, B comma, D comma, G comma, H. Now let us calculate first of A. First of A. So what is first of A here? Here we have two productions. The first production is starting with D. So first of A is nothing but D. And what is the next one? A implies BC. So first of A will become first of B. So what is B here? G comma epsilon. But don't write epsilon here. Here in place of B, substitute epsilon here. If you substitute epsilon here, then what will happen? A implies C. So first of A will become first of C. So what is first of C here? H comma. Here we have epsilon here. Okay. So if you substitute epsilon here, so it will become epsilon. So here the production is add epsilon here. So first of A will become D comma G comma H comma epsilon. Now let us calculate first of B. So first of B means G comma epsilon. Next, first of C means H comma epsilon. Now let us calculate follow. So follow of S is equal to, here there is no S on the right hand side. So follow of S will become dollar symbol. Now let us calculate follow of A. So in order to calculate follow of A, we have to search for the right hand side productions which contains A. Here there is only one production which contains capital A on the right hand side. That production is S implies ACB. Here we are calculating follow of A. Here capital C is following A here. So follow of A will become first of C. Okay. So what is first of C? H comma epsilon. But don't write epsilon here. Why? Because follow doesn't accept epsilon here. Okay. So here what is follow of A? Follow of C. Okay. Here in place of C, substitute epsilon here. So if you substitute epsilon in place of C, then the production will become S implies A into epsilon is nothing but A. So S implies AB. Here we are calculating follow of A. Now the non-terminal capital B is following A here. So follow of A will become first of B. So what is first of B? G comma epsilon. G comma epsilon. But don't write epsilon here because follow doesn't allow epsilon here. So in place of capital B, substitute epsilon. So if we substitute epsilon here, then the production will become A into epsilon. A into epsilon means A. Okay. So follow of A will become, here there is no symbol after the A. So follow of A will become follow of S. So what is follow of S? Dollar symbol. So in this way we can calculate follow of A. Now let us calculate follow of B. So we have to search for capital B in the right hand side. Okay. So how many productions are there? So totally we have 1, 2, 3, 4 productions. Let us consider the first production. S implies ACD. Okay. Next one, S implies CBB. Next one, S implies BA. Next one, A implies BC. So we have to calculate follow for all these productions. So let us consider the first one. So follow of B. Here there is no symbol which is following B here. So follow of B will become follow of S. So what is follow of S? Dollar. So this production is over. Now let us consider the second one. Here there is no symbol is following B here. Okay. So follow of B is nothing but follow of S. So follow of S means dollar. That is already taken. Here small a is following B here. Okay. So follow of B will become A here. Next let us consider this production. Here capital C is following B here. So follow of B will become first of C. But what is first of C? H comma epsilon. But don't write epsilon here. In place of this capital C, substitute epsilon here. Then the production will become A implies B into epsilon. That is nothing but B. So here we are calculating for follow of B. But there is no symbol which is following B here. So follow of B will become follow of A. So what is follow of A? H G dollar. H is already there, but there is no G. Dollar is already there. Okay. So this is nothing but follow of B. Now let us calculate follow of C. So we have to search for the non-terminal capital C in the right hand side. So here we have three projections. The first one is S implies ACB. Second one is S implies CBB. Next one is A implies BC. So follow of C here. Here capital B is following C here. So follow of C will become first of B. So what is first of B? G comma epsilon. G comma, but don't write epsilon here. So in place of B, we need to substitute epsilon here. So if we substitute epsilon, then the production will become S implies AC. Here we are calculating for C here. So no symbol is following C here. So follow of C will become follow of S. So what is follow of S? Dollar. So write dollar here. So this production is over. Now let us consider this production. Here we are calculating follow of C. Here small b is following capital C here. So follow of C will become small b. Because the terminal symbol is following C here. Next A implies BC. Okay. But here after C we don't have any symbol here. So follow of C will become follow of A. So follow of A means H. So there is no H here. H comma G. So G is already there. Dollar is already there. So this is nothing but follow of C. So in this way we can calculate first and follow for this grammar. Now let's see the last one. Now let's see the last example here. So first of S is equal to. So here S contains only one production and it is starting with small a. So first of S is equal to small a. Next first of A is equal to. So two productions C epsilon. So small c comma epsilon. Next, first of B is equal to, it also contains two productions, D comma epsilon. Now let us calculate follow of S. So in order to calculate follow of S, we have to search S for S in RHS. But there is no S here. So follow of S will become dollar here. Next, follow of A. So follow of A means we need to search S for A in right hand side. So what is that production? So S in place, we have only one production. A, A, B, B here. Okay. So follow of A. Here capital B is following A here. So follow of A will become first of B. So what is first of B? D comma epsilon. So D comma, but don't write epsilon here because follow doesn't accept epsilon. Okay. So in place of capital B, we need to substitute epsilon here. So in place of capital B, substitute epsilon. So if you substitute epsilon here, then the production will become AAB. Okay. So now follow of A will become, here small b is following A here. Okay. B symbol. Okay. Next, let us calculate follow of B. So there is only one symbol which is following B. So what is that symbol? B. So in this way, we can calculate first and follow for various grammars.